A tight-knit community in Marysville is reeling after a teenager was hit and killed by a train last night. One other teen remains in the hospital. It happened while a little league game was going on at Earl Yorton Field. That's near Marysville High School. It's where we find Leticia Ordaz this morning, joining us live with a look at what's being done for children there today. Good morning, Leticia.
Well, good morning, May. We're talking to some residents out here in Marysville, and they are absolutely devastated after many witnessed this train crash last night. And this morning, investigators are trying to piece together why those two teens remained on the tracks and did not get off in time. Again, a young boy was killed, and a girl is fighting for her life this morning. We also just spoke with the police chief, and he says they are adding extra patrols to this area. The train collided with the teens just after 7 o'clock last night here on 17th Street and Earl Yorton League baseball field. This all happened while a baseball game was going on. Witnesses reported hearing an emergency horn go off, and an engineer told investigators the teens did not move and he could not get the train to stop in time. Officials say the teens were walking to a school dance, but no one knows why they remained on the tracks. This morning, the police chief says the message to everyone is to stay off the tracks.
Yeah, really the message is kind of multifaceted. You know, the message from the police department is we need to make sure that folks just stay off the easement. Respect the fact that these trains do come through our city all day long, 24 hours a day. We share that message, getting that to the kids and the rest of the community.
And again, the police chief says all weekend long, patrols will be out here just to make sure that people are safe around the tracks. In the meantime, a baseball game is set to take place here at the Little League Park in just 30 minutes. And we understand that grief counselors will be on hand for anyone in need. In the meantime, the victims in this crash have not been identified. And we're still waiting to hear if the young girl who is in the hospital will survive. Reporting live here in Marysville, I'm Leticia Ordaz, KCRA 3 News.
Thank you, Leticia.